for period of 5 years going to now 6. Hecheki started in 2018. And vile tulianza na penye tuko, the journey has been a lesson. I can tell you for a fact that wenye tulianza nao si wenye tuko nao sahi. Many have dropped along the way, and there are those who have remained. There are those who have championed hyperhidrosis awareness with us, with the HAK, from the onset. Paka sahi. I don't want to start mentioning names, but they know themselves. They may not have contributed a certain amount of money. You know the kind of contribution they've given. Time. When there's an event, they work, even if they are not there physically. They are very active, ukoko background. On the background, they are working, they are cheering, they give their contribution in and out. On screen, off screen, online, offline. And this is because of what Hyperhidrosis Awareness Kenya is to them. And we are talking about impact. You see, the journey started January 12th, 2018, at exactly 7 p.m. in the evening, usiku. I was still the office. So mikakati zilikuwa zimeanza from 2017 when I now decided, you know what, I want to do this. I don't want to procrastinate anymore. I don't think that I'm the only person with excessive sweating. There are other people out there with sweat issues. But no one is talking about it. Even if there was an organization, let's say there's an organization out there that was talking about hyperhidrosis and other sweat-related issues, then your awareness haikukuwa na hiyo muscle. I know kama tunaelewana hapo. Even if they were talking about it, they were not making a lot of noise about it, or they were not connecting. You know, there is a way you can address an issue and talk about it. Na unapata, it's not reaching out or connecting. The word here is connecting. Una vile connect na mtu. The best example would be music. There are certain music that will remind you of a situation. It reminds you of where you are, who you are with, and what you're doing. So tunaangalia in different scenarios. A music can remind you of something. Music has the ability to take you down memory lane. So even when it comes to awareness, it's the same thing. Awareness has to hit that core for it to connect with you, for you to see yourself. And the best way to do it is to speak to that person. And when I launched Hyperhidrosis Initiative, for those who are new, if you've joined our WhatsApp group or you follow our Facebook page, HAK has a journey. We have a serious journey, and I'm waiting for the time where we are going to celebrate our 10-year anniversary. And which reminds me, for a very long period of time, I don't think we've ever celebrated our anniversary as HAK. 5 years is a lot. 5 years is a lot. And there's a lot to celebrate. There's a lot to appreciate. Because for the first time, there is an organization. For the first time, we can be heard. For the first time, we can talk. You can talk to HAK and not feel judged. You don't have to hide anything. You don't have to feel ashamed. To me, that's a milestone. At Akama, we don't have a physical location. But the fact that we connect, HAK has given us that platform to connect. You can talk to someone about your sweat issues. Not just talk, but get solutions. That's a blessing. 2018 at 7, we launched HAK, no, sorry, Hyperhidrosis Initiative, already launched. I had these assets, video assets, that during the period of time as I was planning and working towards the launch, I would record myself working out because it had a purpose and an end goal. The goal was, we are going to raise awareness on hyperhidrosis. We are going to cycle from Nairobi to Kisumu. Man, that was like, unaskia set goals and make them higher so that you never go anything below ilikuwa hivyo. So I'm working out. I did my workout for about 8 months. And at the time, I was going through a lot of depression. I got broken hearted. Story for another day. But during that period, it was very challenging for me. You would see me on TV, there with Victoria Rubadiri on K24. I'm talking about all this stuff, and people are connecting. But kwa background, mimi sikuwa niko sawa. I remember after the launch, I mean, we all do it. You launch a page and you expect that traction, you expect people to interact, and I didn't see anything. So in a way, ikaanza kuni disappoint because now those voices of you're the only one with this issue. Is it going to work? And then you're meeting people, and these were the guys then who I thought were in my circle. And there was this one in particular who kept telling me, you know, you're not going to make it. Hakuna vile utafika Kisumu. Cycling, it's not easy. You're not going to do it. You see, when you start entertaining such noises, those voices, they get you. Then sasa sa zile uko peke yako, you start now preaching to yourself. Alafu ile unaanza kusema, nanye ni ukweli. Sioni kama naweza make. I can tell you, I received more you can't. Hauta make, hautaweza. Hata kuna mwingine aliniambia, Buda hutoboi, you won't do it, haiwezekani. But there were those few voices that echoed and they said, Martin, go for it, you have my support. Others prayed for me. And the more I kept sharing posts, yes, I'll get likes here and there. But these likes were from my former colleagues, the people that knew me. I was waiting for someone living with hyperhidrosis. Until one day, I just took my phone and I went to the parking lot and I started talking and I said, you see, I don't think I'm the only one with excessive sweating. There is someone out there. Now, Joe Kwapo, and that video is there. It's an old video. It's an old video, but Iko. And it is through that video that I connected with Evelyn Juma. 5 years later, she's a very different person. So everything, it's a journey. As I was working towards now the awareness campaign, you know, you cannot raise awareness on anything to do with health without the Ministry of Health. They have to be involved. So I wrote to them. Now, at the time, I think they were rolling out devolution. So it may happen, health bado zilikuwa on national level. So I had to go and get an authorization letter for me to be able to do, you know, the awareness activities, which it took around 3 months, the government. But what was very surprising is the feedback I received that the disease is not new in the country. It simply lacks awareness. I was very surprised. I'm getting official communication from the government of Kenya that hyperhidrosis is not new in the country, simply lacks awareness. So there are two ways of looking at it. Either get angry, start lashing out at the government, you government are supposed to do this and that, or become the problem solver.